like an astronaut that's scared of heights, with a heart that's beating. Alright guys, let's get this tutorial started. So the first thing you guys know already is to prime our eyelids, and I'm using my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in the shade NC15. As always, this concealer has the technology built in it to prime for eyeshadow while concealing. Now I'm going to be taking scotch tape. Yes, you heard me. We're back at it, just like old times. And I'm going to line it from the outer corner of my eye up to the tail of my brow, trying to get them as even as possible. Now I'm going to be taking my Urban Decay Naked 2 palette and taking the color Tease. And I'm going to be taking a BH Cosmetics fluffy crease brush, and I'm going to start placing that from in my crease and also in my outer V, focusing most of the pigmentation in that outer corner in the eye, and just start slowly sweeping it in all the way into the inner corner. But again, focus this main color in the outer corner of your eye. Make sure to blend everything out, because in this look there are no harsh lines. Now I'm going to be taking the color Pistol, I believe. I'll, make sure to check next time. And I'm going to be taking a dense crease brush by BH Cosmetics. And again, I'm going to do the exact same thing. Focus this color mainly in the outer corner and slowly start sweeping it up into my crease and in my inner corner. But again, focusing the main color in the outer portion of my eye, because that's where it's going to be like the main attention in the eyeshadow. So again, just start working it, pack it on that outer V and in that outer portion of your eye, and then slowly start working it into your crease. Now this is totally optional, you don't have to do this, but I'm going to be taking Barcelona Beach by Makeup Geek, and I'm going to again take the same dense crease brush and place that in the outer V and the outer portion of my eye, and start sweeping it in to my inner corner. I just decided to add this color because I felt like I needed to blend a little bit more and add a little bit more of warm tones into the look. So again, totally optional, you don't have to do this. Now I'm going to be taking Blackout and from the Urban Decay Naked 2 palette and an angled brush. And now working with blacks can be very, very tricky, since again it's very pigmented and they're hard to blend. So slowly start packing on the black in the outer V, and then slowly start working it into your crease, and take some Tease and start blending it out. Again, blending is the key when you are working with dark colors, and especially in this look. So you're going to be switching around your brush a lot, so take some black, pack it on wherever you want to put it, then start blending it out with a different brush with some Tease, and keep going back and forth until you're satisfied with the pigmentation. Now I'm going to be taking Foxy and Booty Call, and I'm going to place this in my lid, but not going all the way out since I put those blacks and all that stuff. So just place it in the area that you didn't put any other eyeshadow, and make sure to pack it on where the pigmentation can stay on your eye. And then I'm going to go back with some more black and put it in the outer V, since we packed a lot of some light eyeshadow, it's going to make it fade out. And now I'm going to be removing my tape. I know this kind of looks painful, but I promise it was not. And as you can see, it creates a nice dramatic line. Now I'm going to be creating a nice cat wing liner using my NYC High Definition Liquid Eyeliner. And it should look something like this. As you can see, we're going to later on create the inner cat eye. And then I'll be cutting my lashes with some mascara, and then placing the Broadway eyes. I'm going to prime my face with my favorite primer, which is the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer, as always, to help the longevity of my foundation and give it a lot smoother canvas. And using my favorite foundation, which is the Smashbox Studio Skin Hydrating Foundation. And I'm going to be applying that with my Real Techniques Beauty Sponge. When
And now I'm going to highlight with my MAC Pearl Longwear Concealer. And I'm going to be placing it under my eyes, in the bridge of my nose, my forehead, and in my chin, and blending it out with my Real Techniques Beauty Sponge. And now I'm going to set my highlight with this shade right here from the NYX Contour and Highlight Pearl Palette. And using my Sigma Tapered Highlighter Brush, I'm going to be using padding. Oh dear, here I am, breaking out in dance mode. Super random. Anyway, so yeah, I'm going to set my under eye and everywhere else that I highlighted. And using my Makeup Forever Pro Finish Powder in the shade 117 to set the rest of my face. And I'm using a, if I'm not mistaken, I'm using my Morphe powder brush. Now I'm going to be doing my brows off camera because I don't feel like you need to see that, and voila! It was an okay day. I wasn't very proud of my brows, so it's kind of sad dance. Now I'm going to be taking all the colors that I placed in my eyes and in my crease and everything in my lower lash line, but I'm not going to be taking it all the way into my inner corner since we're going to create that cat eye, you know, with the eyeliner and everything. So I'm just going to sweep kind of like almost to the inner third of my eye, and I'm going to be again packing all the colors. And now I'm here and I'm trying to show you how I created the little cat eyeliner. I line the little inner corner and then I create like a little triangle with the same liquid liner that I used to create my cat eyeliner. It should end up looking something like this. Try to make them as even as possible. Now, taking any eyeliner pencil, I'm going to be lining my waterline and tight lining my top lash line. And here I am looking like if I'm in so much pain, but I promise I am in no pain. Now I'm going to contour, and I'm going to be using this shade right here from the NYX Contour and Highlight Palette. And I'm going to be using the Sonia Kashuk number 30 contour brush, which is my new obsession for contouring. It just makes it so much faster and so much easier, and I am totally obsessed with it, and it was definitely worth my money. It's not super expensive. I think it was like $15 for this brush, but I'm just totally obsessed with it. I totally recommend it. So I'm just going to be contouring under my cheekbones, in my temples, and in my jawline, and adding a little bit in my nose, just to even out that highlight that we did a while back.